In this lesson, we will understand what are data types in C language. With that, we will also see the data types used in C language. That would be really helpful for us in the upcoming lessons. Let us start. A data type is an attribute of data that tells the compiler or interpreter how the programmer intends to use the data. So consider data types as the kind of data that can be stored and manipulated within a program. The following are the two types of data types in C language, basic and derived. Let us understand them. Basic data types are the fundamental data types in C. Beginning with int, as the name suggests, int is integer. The int data type in C is used to store integer values, which are whole numbers without any decimal points. It is one of the fundamental data types provided by the C language and is widely used in various programming scenarios. Okay, it is used for integers, that is to store integer values. The size of int can vary depending on the system architecture, but it is typically 4 bytes, that is 32 bits on most modern systems. In the bottom, we have shown how to declare and initialize an integer variable. Int space num, int is the data type, num is the variable name, and the value after equal is 10, that is the num variable is initialized to 10. Okay, so this was an integer variable. Next comes float. Float is related to double. So let us understand them. Float and double are data types used to store floating point numbers, but they have different characteristics in terms of precision and memory usage. Float is used for single precision floating point numbers, whereas double is used for double precision floating point numbers. That means when you want higher precision, go for the double data type. The size of float is 4 bytes, whereas the size of double data type is 8 bytes. Float is suitable for applications where memory is constrained and the precision requirement is moderate, whereas double is preferred when higher precision is required. The memory usage of float is less than what double uses. Here is an example below. Using float and double, we have initialized two variables, float pi and double large number. Next is char. Char, as the name suggests, is for characters, that is to store single characters. It is one of the fundamental data types in C. Its size is typically 1 byte, that is 8 bits. It is used to store single characters such as letters and symbols. Strings in C are arrays of this char only, that is terminated by a null character. So we will work around these data types in the upcoming lessons in our programs. We will also use the char data type to create strings in C language. Here is an example in the end. Char space letter. Letter is our variable here. And using this, we have stored a single character A. So these were the basic data types in C language. Let us now see the derived data types. These are built from the basic data types only. They offer a unique way to store and manipulate data in C. Beginning with arrays, it is a collection of elements of the same type. Pointers store the memory address of another variable. Pointers allow you to directly interact with memory. They are variables that store memory addresses, typically the addresses of other variables. Structures used to group different data types into a single unit. So array is for similar type, whereas structures are for different data types. Unions can be related with structures, but they share the same memory location for their members. So we will study all of them in the upcoming lessons. The last one is enumeration. It is a user-defined data type that consists of integral constants. Enum is short for enumeration. It consists of a set of named integer constants. It is used to assign names to the integral constants, which makes the code more readable and maintainable. In the upcoming lessons, we will study these basic and derived data types in the form of lessons, topics, and codes. So guys, in this lesson, we saw what are data types in C language, what are its types. Thank you for watching the video.